Okay, welcome everyone. My name is Tal Frankfurt, and I'm the founder and CEO of Cloud for Good. Together with me, I have the Conga team. Shelley, can you hear me?
Yes, hi.
Hi, Shelley. So the webinar today is part of a series of webinars that Cloud for Good is offering at no cost to the nonprofit community called Apps for Good. You can find more information about our webinars and the future webinars if you go to our website under Resources, click on Webinars, and you'll see that we have many upcoming webinars. We've already had Form Assembly and Cirrus and Click and Pledge, and next, I think the next presentation is from CauseView, and then again Click and Pledge are on event management. We have auction management, volunteers, GeoPoint, and many more. The webinar is on mute, so if you have any questions, please put them in that chat window. We will address all your questions at the end of the webinar today. And with that being said, Shelley, the floor is yours.
Well, thanks so much, Tal. We're really excited to be here. It's, my name is Shelley Houlihan, and I'm a senior business analyst at Conga. We make Conga Composer for Salesforce.com, and I also have my colleague Chris Cook, who is our Director of Business Development here. So I'm going to be kind of the point of contact on the webinar, but Chris is probably going to chime in from time to time as well. And between the two of us, I think we have almost 9 years of experience at Conga. So you guys are in hopefully very good hands, and we have a long history with Cloud for Good and are really pleased to be in the webinar today and working with you all and love the nonprofit community. So very excited to show you guys Conga.
I think that Conga is probably one of the most common applications that we install for our clients. You know, almost all our clients need a good way to manage, you know, to generate their thank you letters or event invitations, labels, and stuff like that. So Conga is definitely one of my favorite apps.
Oh, great. Well, thank you, Tal. So what I wanted to do today was just go through the, I have a bit of a slide deck, and then definitely want to show the demo for all of our attendees so they can see what Conga does and just the power behind it and how it all works.
And Shelley, do you know how to share your desktop?
I am just getting...
technology. I think if you click on the, there's in the little bar there, it says share desktop.
Okay. I think we've got it here.
Yep.
So
we
you
can see your screen.
Can use my browser now.
That's all we see.
So just one moment, you guys, and I'm going to pull up the slide deck here. So sorry, we got into our conference room. We're very fast-growing company, so everybody's always clamoring for these conference rooms, and I got kicked out a little bit or got in here late. Someone was using it. So my apologies, and I will grab my file here.
Sheila, we see right now window no shared.
Oh, okay, just one second. Sorry, you guys. You'd think working in a technology company, I'd be a little bit more adept at this, but full of bumpy issues today. Okay, so just one second, and I think you guys should be able to see.
Probably want to click on share desktop or share a specific application.
Just do this. Okay, so you can see the PowerPoint?
We can see you now.
Oh, great. Okay. Okay, so again, just thank you everyone for attending. My apologies for these technical difficulties at the beginning, but I'm just going to go through these slides rather quickly because I think the really interesting part is probably the demo portion. So Conga Composer is the name of our application, and it's just what it says it is here on the title, Streamlining Document Generation and Reporting for Salesforce. Documents is really our bread and butter. That's what we're really good at. And the general idea is to pull data from Salesforce.com and populate that into templates or documents. Those can be Word, Excel, PowerPoint, PDF, and now we have the ability to do HTML email as well. So a little bit about our company. We have over 3,000 customers, over 80,000 users in 35 countries around the world. So since 2006, we've really just taken off, largely thanks to folks like Tal who really spread the word for us and the nonprofit community. We get really good of word of mouth. And that's kind of what you see here. These are snapshots of some of our reviews on the App Exchange for our Conga Composer app. People generally love the app. We also pride ourselves on really high level of customer service and support. And I think that really comes into play with the nonprofit folks, because a lot of times you might be new to Salesforce and you're not entirely sure, you know, how to set things up. And that's where we come in, and with folks like Tal and Cloud for Good, to sort of the 1-2 punch of getting your Salesforce environment set up and then getting Conga going to generate those documents that you need. So this is from one of our very enthusiastic customers we've had since 2006, and she created this little image as a joke and mailed it over to us, but she just said, "I couldn't live without Conga. I don't know how I'd do my job without it." So we're very lucky that we have some pretty rabid fans out there in the Salesforce community. We're consistently one of the top AppExchange applications, consistently in the top 10. Six consecutive years, so since our founding, we've been essentially always in the top 10, so very lucky for that. And then this is just a little bit about who we are. We were founded in 2006. We don't have any commissioned salespeople. We are obviously an AppExchange partner, being one of the apps on the AppExchange. We purchase wind credits to offset our carbon footprint, so we like to say that we're the only 100% wind-powered app on the AppExchange. And again, like we talked about earlier, we do have customers all over the world. So just a little bit about us. And then this is about who we serve. I've highlighted there in the lower left corner the nonprofit and education industries, just since that's who you folks are, obviously. But we do work with all sorts of industries, but definitely have a big presence in the nonprofit community. And then this is just a little bit about some of the customers we work with. You see the nonprofits on the left and enterprise on the right, but you know, everybody from American Red Cross, you know, really large organizations, down to you know, kind of mom and pop sort of animal rescue organizations that, you know, are four volunteers running it out of their house. So regardless of your scale, we can work with you and your users and your level of Salesforce experience. This is simply just to show a little bit about the sorts of solutions that we can provide across different departments within your organization. So, you know, a lot of these might be more, you might think that's more of an enterprise sort of thing. We don't have a marketing department. We don't have a, you know, a sales team or whatever. But I know with a lot of the nonprofits we talk to, you do have all those departments. It's just that they might be all combined into one person's role. You know, it's the true epitome of someone wearing multiple hats. So you might come to us for a specific problem. "Hey, Shelley, we really have a hard time generating donation acknowledgement letters. It's very tedious." But then once you learn how to use the Conga application and get that data out of Salesforce and into your documents, you'll start to think about other ways you can use this. So this is kind of a slide to hopefully spark your imagination and think about, well, we need to, you know, submit invoices to our vendors, and we have legal forms that we have to keep on file and that sort of thing. We do fully integrate with a few e-signature solutions. The three probably biggest ones on the AppExchange are DocuSign, Adobe EchoSign, and Certify. So if you all have the need to generate a document, you know, maybe it is something where you're working with a vendor and you need them to sign off on it, You can have Conga Composer pull the data from Salesforce and generate that document and then send it to that recipient via one of those e-signature solutions, and then they can sign it using DocuSign or EchoSign or Certify and then send it back into Salesforce. Chris just made me a little note here. Another great idea for that is if you have volunteer forms, very applicable in your industry, that you oftentimes have to get those folks to sign a waiver. So if you're using an e-signature tool, that can really streamline that process. And then once they sign it, again, all that data goes back into Salesforce. You've got it all on file, of course, in the cloud. So, you know, gosh forbid, if you were out at an event and someone, you know, needed to sign, you can do that all on your mobile devices and it's all there. So very cool. So then we're going to get into a little bit of a discussion or presentation on exactly what Conga does. So the problem is that you have all this great data in Salesforce, but getting it out of Salesforce and distributed to customers, partners, employees, volunteers, vendors, like we've talked about, is very difficult. So often that involves things like copying and pasting data, whether it's right from Salesforce or maybe you use a report to export it to Excel, and then you're copy-pasting that into Word and reformatting everything. It just is very time-consuming. You're also, during those sorts of processes, prone to errors just because everybody's doing it a little bit differently. They have their own process that they go through, and you might run into errors, which is not good, especially when you have those really important things like how much did this person donate. You don't want that number to get skewed. So that's where Salesforce and Conga Composer come in, that you've got a consistent process. It's literally a click of a button. Conga will do the same thing every time. Everybody's using the same versions of things. So if you do have those dedicated marketing and legal departments, they'll be really pleased because it's all very consistent up to your brand and your legal guidelines. So part of the Conga Composer application that we're going to highlight today is what we call Conga Mail Merge. The asterisk that you see at the top is just denoted in the lower right that it's included with the Conga Composer application. So if I demo anything today that is an additional cost on top of the main application, I'll definitely be sure to highlight that so you guys know. But this is one that's included with the flagship application. And the idea with this is just that you can print mailing labels, envelopes, and documents directly from Salesforce. And the great thing about this is that you can run a batch. So you can have, you know, thousands of records maybe at a time that you need to generate a letter and a label for. And Conga will pull that data from Salesforce, push it into the letter, create a coordinating label, and then you can just print those. Hopefully you have a team of interns to stuff all those envelopes, and then you're good to go. So Conga Composer, again, this is just kind of highlighting the really strong suits of the application. So you can pull any data from any object. It's your document in your format, and then you can deliver that how you want. Now with Conga Mail Merge, it's going to be a download and print, but with the other side of the application, the Composer, which we'll show you as well, you can do email and e-signature and that sort of thing. And then this is just to highlight our whole suite of products. So Conga Composer is the, you know, overall application that's in orange. The blue guy, Conga Mail Merge, is included within that. And then the ones that you see down here in bold green, Conductor and Workflow, those are paid add-ons. But they work in conjunction with Composer. So we'll go over a little bit of that later in the demo. And then Conga Courier is sort of out here on its own. It's a separate application also made by our company. It's the ability to schedule an email Salesforce report. And the really cool thing about that is you don't have to always do that to internal users as you would with the Salesforce report emailing tool. You can specify Salesforce contacts as well. And then you can pick your own schedule down to the hour of when you want to send it. So it's really neat. But we're not going to highlight that so much today. We think the document generation is more so what you guys will be interested in for today. So what does this mean for you? Again, it's just the ability to create, distribute, and automate. It's just streamlining that process to make it so simple so that you're not running into errors, you're not having everybody do their own little process, you've got all the data recorded in Salesforce, and no questions, you're good to go. it's easier for everyone as well. It just makes it super, super simple. We're literally going to show you how you create a button. It's a click here, a click there, and you're done. So you as the administrator will be setting all of this up in the background, but the users, it's going to be so, so simple. And even for the admins, it doesn't require coding. I'm not somebody who even knows HTML, much less Visual Force, but it's going to be really, really simple for you all. So what does it cost? That's always a question on our minds, especially with nonprofits. You want to keep those budgets down. You want to keep the dollars where they're meant to go, to your cause, not to these sort of overhead sort of situations. So we're have a commitment to the nonprofit community. We have always offered a generous discount, and it's one-third off or 33% off our list price of $144 per user per year. So that works out to you all for $96 per user per year. So if you're doing monthly budgeting, that works out to $8 per user per month. We do bill annually, so keep that in mind, but we do like to provide that monthly equivalent just so you can kind of see the math. The technical support is included, so you're never going to pay a setup cost, a maintenance cost. You know, don't be worried to call us or email if you're struggling with something. That is all built in, so you're not going to have to pay anything. That $96 per user per year is the whole cost out the door. So the only other thing that you need to know, we do have a 5-user minimum, so 5 users times $96, you're looking at $480 for your introductory plan. And then any additional users, you can purchase just one, you can purchase 10. You don't have to purchase them in blocks or anything like that. Those are $96 a piece as well. So this is all she wrote, as they said, $96 a piece. Okay, so we're going to go into the demo now, and certainly, if you all have any questions, I think there's a tool in the ReadyTalk conference. Tal, maybe you can jump in really quick. Are we kind of saving questions till the end?
Yeah, I think we'll save the questions to the end unless I think there's going to be something urgent or something that is very relevant, and I'll just pick it up from the chat window.
Okay,
and ask. But yeah, guys, if there is a chat window, please feel free to post your questions, and I'm moderating them.
Okay, great. So we're in Salesforce, and I've already gone ahead and installed the Conga Composer application into our environment. This is just a test environment I have, so it's all dummy data. So if you see a contact that you know, it's just coincidence. I promise I didn't steal their information. But what I'm going to start with is Conga Mail Merge. So once you install the application, you will go to a tab called Conga Mail Merge in your Salesforce instance. And I like to think of it as a wizard. You're going to start out on this orange page, and you'll see in the upper right corner where it says Step 1 of 7. So what we're doing here is creating that batch of documents or labels or envelopes, as you see here. So the idea is that you want to create one or more of these items for a batch of people. So the use case that I've set up here is I have a bunch of people who recently attended an event and donated a lot of money, and I want to send them follow-up letters just to confirm the amount that they donated so they have those for their tax purposes, as well as just thank them for coming and, you know, to highlight a bit about our organization and our cause and what we're doing. So the first step, very simple, you're just going to select what you want to generate. So I'm going to do letters and envelopes for this particular batch. Just click Next. And on this next page, you're going to select your data source. So once this loads here, you'll see that you can choose either a report, which is what I prefer. I think it's the most flexible and the most powerful because you can select any sort of object. So that's what I'm going to be doing, but you'll see also that you can run this based off of a campaign, which oftentimes is very useful if you're using campaigns to track event attendees or something like that, and then accounts, leads, and contacts as well. So if you do select something like this, then you'll be presented with sort of a Salesforce list view sort of criteria filters where you could say, you know, we only want folks who live in Colorado or something like that. But for today, I'm going to do reports. And the particular one that I want to use is donation acknowledgments. So all of the reports that you're seeing in this list are stored in a folder called Conga Reports. So if you didn't see the particular one that you wanted to use, you can always just go out to your Salesforce Reports folder and create a new one. I'm going to click this View Report button in the lower right corner just so you guys can see the sort of data that's driving this. It might look really boring because I simply have an ID column on here. This is the Salesforce record ID of, I'm in a for-profit instance, so it's opportunities, but normally this might be like your donation ID. And what that does, Conga comes in and reads those record IDs and it says, okay, we have 10 records of opportunities. I'm going to go out and retrieve all of the fields on that opportunity record. And then as a bonus, Conga will also retrieve if you're using opportunities or donations and you have a primary contact role, it will retrieve that data as well. So in our merge process, we'll then have all of these fields right off of the opportunity that you see, as well as down here where we have the contact role of Dagny, like she's marked primary. It'll go off to her contact and retrieve all of that data as well. So it's sort of a two-for-one with this report. So really, we could add other columns to this, like opportunity name and amount and close date if we wanted to, but really the only thing that Conga needs to run is that ID column. So to make it easier to read for humans, so to speak, you could certainly add additional comments, or excuse me, columns, but all Conga needs is that one ID column. So I'm going to jump back to the Mail Merge Wizard, and we'll just keep going through our steps here. We'll just click Next, and on this next page, it just did that because I set up this and put a field filter in, and it thinks I still want to do that. So we'll just clear that out, go back to Reports, and click Next. And then on this next page, it'll show us all of the records from our report. So just in the interest of time, again, I had kind of limited that to 10. But you can have thousands of records in here if you had such a batch. Conga Mail Merge can handle that. So you'll see up at the top, it'll show you how many master records you found. So that would be donations. And then if we were doing a report that was like opportunities with products, then it would tell you how many detail records there were as well. So the details would be those products spread across all those master records. What I like about
I have a quick question about reports here. Do you have to use the record ID, or can you create reports without IDs?
You can certainly customize your report however you like, Tal, and you know use whatever objects and all of that. But Conga does need to have that ID column on the report because that's how it knows basically however many IDs, unique IDs there are on that report is how many unique letters you're going to get. So, for example, if you were using a master detail type of report like accounts with contacts, you would want to choose your account as your ID column on the report because there might be 2, 3, 5, 10 contacts on each report, on each account. So when Conga Mail Merge runs and it sees that account ID column, it would then know, okay, rather than creating one letter for each contact, I simply want to send it to each account. Maybe it's a family. And then we can list the contact names within the letter or something like that. So yes, you do need to have an ID column.
Great.
But yeah, you can certainly have other fields as well and customize that in whatever other ways you like. So what I like about this particular page, the review search results page, is that let's say, for example, that I had already sent a thank you letter to the folks at Reardon Steel, so in the Vallejo processing plant, so I'm just going to uncheck their record, and now I'm only going to create 9. So it's cool in that way that you can just kind of review who's in here and then uncheck records or check them as you need. Click Next, and then it's simply asking which letter or document template we'd like to use for our merge process. So for the letter, I'm going to select Donation Acknowledgement, and if you want to, you can click View Template, and it would pull up that Word template and show you the results there. So you can see here Let me turn off the paragraph formatting. We've got just each of these that you see here with the double arrows on either side is a merge field. So I've built this out previously and stored it into Salesforce so that we can now just run it right through Conga Mail Merge and get a letter for each of these. So you can see that the dynamic parts are the full name, the today field, the address, first name, and then opportunity amount. So we're not doing anything too crazy here. We are merging in a signature image, so that'll be kind of cool. But just to give you guys kind of an idea, these are all built in Microsoft Word, so hopefully a platform that you're familiar with, and then we'll show you how to build these merge fields and do the support there so that if you're not sure how that all works, that's where the support team and our online resources on our support website come into play. So after I've selected my template, I just click Next. And then it's asking me which envelope I want to do. So you can certainly do a standard envelope size, like 10 is really popular, and you can specify whether you want to include a return address on that or not. And it will just use the primary contact role in our particular case and their mailing address on the envelope. I went a little bit fancier and I built my own, so I'm just going to select this second option for choose an envelope template from Salesforce, and then it's stored right here, donation acknowledgement envelope. And those envelopes where I built that template was also in Microsoft Word, so very similar to the letter template that I showed you all earlier. So now you're on the last page, and very easy here, you just click Letters Documents to download your letters, and then once those are finished, we can go back and do the envelopes. So usually this takes maybe 15 seconds. It does depend if you have a lot more records or your template is very complex. Obviously that can contribute to the time it takes to process, but usually it's just a minute or two at the most. So you can see now in Word that I've got my output file, and all those dynamic pieces have now updated with, you know, this is just today's date, but the rest of this is information from Salesforce, the contact full name and address, and then you can see down here where we did the amount, and then that signature image is actually stored on my user record and it's being merged in. So that's kind of cool as well. So we should have 9 records here, or 10, I guess there were 10 in the report. But you can see, you know, each one is different, Ellis Wyatt and so forth. Oh, the 10th. Oh, sorry, I forgot. I'd unchecked the one in the review results, and I think this one was just a little bit longer, so it bled over onto a second page. So, but those are the letters. We'll just minimize that for right now. And then let me go back into Salesforce, and we'll do the envelope. Oh, yeah. Chris just made an excellent point. You do not have to start over here, so we're just remaining on the same page and you can click envelope. So again, we're trying to just streamline this and make it as easy for folks as possible. So you can see I've got a little return address with kind of our logo there in the corner, and then each person is coming through as that's the primary contact role, and then sort of the organization or company that they're associated with. Yeah, and it does come in. Chris, you can speak up. Don't be shy. He keeps piping in with all these good notes. They do come out in the same order as the letters, so very easy to collate and stuff those envelopes once you print each of these files. So with the envelopes, very easily you just load the envelopes into your printer and print away. Super simple. Same idea with a label. If you wanted to do a label, we can do, you know, any of the standard labels like Avery 5160 is a very popular one. But if you have a more off-kilter size or something that's not as common, you can certainly build a custom label template into Word, and we can build that or work with that as well. So another little tool on the last step here, whoops. So that just shows you, if you do that show details, it just gives you sort of a summary of what we did, how many records there were, and so forth. What I really wanted to show you all was this log activities section, which is a huge plus in my opinion. So if you've merged to, kept your output file as Word, which you can certainly do a PDF output, but if you're going to print them, you know, it probably doesn't really matter one way or the other. But if you're going to save them and distribute them, you might want them to be PDF to be locked down so that nobody could edit that. You always have the option of doing one file. If it's 40 megabytes or less, then it'll be just one consolidated Word or PDF file. If not, then if it's bigger than 40 megs, you will get a multiple file, meaning it's a zip file. But the log activity section is really cool. What you can do, if you did do a merge to Word up here, then you can select this yes, and it will take the body of your letter, which was here. So it'll take the date, and you know it won't do images, but all of the text, and it essentially copy-pastes that into the comments section of an activity logged into Salesforce. So whatever ID column you chose on your report, if you guys remember, I did an opportunity ID, it will log one completed task under activity history for each of those individual letters. So you can give it a subject like donation acknowledgement sent. And if you wanted to do a follow-up task, like you wanted to call all of your donors a week after, then you could log that as well. And then it's simply just click log activities. And you just get a message just to make sure that you didn't click that by accident. We give you a little way to back out if you need to. And then this will just take, again, a few seconds, or maybe up to a minute, depending on how many records you have. But we can pull up a record and we'll go see this. But it's nice, in this red text, you'll get this confirmation message that the activities were logged for those 9 records.
This is Chris. I'm going to chime in. The real benefit, I think, to that in the nonprofit space is that by logging that activity, not only do you have a record of what was sent, but who sent it and when. Mm-hmm. So that if you've got multiple people and different folks at different times working on different campaigns or events or notifications, that using that activity logging really ensures that as long as you're in Salesforce, you can tell when those have been sent so you don't resend them or you don't miss anybody as well. And with different folks that might be part-time, more Salesforce savvy, less Salesforce savvy, being able to know at the record level what was sent and when really makes it consistent and easy. And that can even be something that you would use as a filter in that report. And Shelley showed that report of those donations, that as part of a filter you could include one of those other records to ensure that you don't duplicate those donor letters or one doesn't get missed. So just that continuity and consistency, regardless of who's doing that process, is really key.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just excellent for record keeping and sort of that, just kind of your legal obligation that you sent somebody an acknowledgement and they have that for tax purposes, or, you know, you did send them the volunteer waiver and they signed it, or whatever it happens to be. So
especially for large donations as well, or large groups of letters, to be able to do that as a batch certainly saves a lot of manual input time too.
Yeah. So we're going to go look at Dagny Taggart. And actually, let me look at her envelope, because that will have the particular organization that she's associated to. There she is. Okay, so she's Taggart Transcontinental. I'm just going to search for her record in Salesforce so we can show you guys what the activity looks like. So again, that was against her her contact, her donation. Her opportunity in my little instance here. So you can see that Dagny Taggart is the primary contact role. And then if we go up to the activity history, I had a few old ones from a few days ago, but that donation acknowledgement sent is the one that we're looking at. And if we click on that, it contains the body of that letter. So just a really good record keeping, like Chris said, it's just, you know, so helpful that you can see, hey, Shelley logged that letter on July 25th in the afternoon. It's done. It's a really good just little check to make sure you've got everything you need. So that Conga mail merge, the wizard, you know, while it's not difficult, these seven steps that you go through, if you were having to do this, you know, maybe every week or every other day or, you know, even every month, you might, how do I do this? What do I do again? Which steps do I do? You might forget. It might just get a little bit tedious if you're doing this really often to go through all those steps every time. So we have a free custom object that you can add on to your Conga Composer application, and it's called Quick Merge Links. So this you can install from the Conga Merge website, congamerge.com, and what it does is just installs this custom object into your Salesforce environment. And what you can do is build a record. So you can see here I'm on the Quick Merge link detail. What I've done is just set up the exact same solution we just went through in the Mail Merge tab. I'm now just going to default each of those seven steps in this Quick Merge record so that when I click Launch and I have this check mark enabled for Bypass Wizard, I just go straight to the very last page of that Mail Merge wizard and I just have to download my letters and my envelopes. So all you have to do is put in your template ID for your letter, and then if you're doing envelopes or labels, the template IDs for those as well. And you might be saying, well, where the heck do I get a template ID? Part of the Conga Composer application is an object called Conga Templates. So this is where you're going to store that Word file that I showed you all at the beginning for the donation acknowledgement letter. I just gave it a name up here. And then you can put in a description and what the template type is and so forth, but you're just going to click Attach File and upload that Microsoft Word document. And that can be .docx or .doc. Either platform will work equally well. Same thing for the envelope.
Now, Shelley, before we have tons of questions coming up, but I just want to highlight, we need to make sure that we have some time, but if you can go back to the template, one of the things that many of our customers are using when they use Conga are the fields to set. So can you talk just name a little bit about that?
Yeah, great point. So master field to set, if you all are at all familiar with Salesforce workflow rules where you can do a field update as a result of a workflow rule, it's the same idea, but instead of doing a field update as the result of a workflow rule, you can change a field value anytime you do a Conga mail merge process. So you could say, every time I generate this donation acknowledgement letter back on my opportunity, I want to update the stage from pending to closed, or you know, update a date field to, you know, maybe you have a field called letter acknowledgement sent, you know, and you can update that to today's field. And every time a subsequent letter gets sent, it'll update to that day's date. So that's what we do with master field to set. It's simply a matter of referencing the field that you want to update via the Salesforce API name, and then an equal sign, and then whatever value. So you can see, like in that second example, it says status underscore date underscore underscore C. That's the API field name of a field called status date, and then equals, and just the word today will update that date field to today's date. So it's a really another good way of record keeping and tracking what you've done in Salesforce, as to what Chris was saying earlier. I'm going to acknowledge Paula's question that just came up really quickly because we're on that topic. She asked if we're limited to three fields to update. You are limited to three fields here on the template record. But within your Microsoft Word template, so on this guy, you can actually build in master field to set fields here as well. So they don't show up anywhere on your actual merge letter. They're just used in the background by Conga to do further field updates. So you can actually do up to six, Paula, would be the total.
Let me add on top of that, you don't really need more than three, even though it looks like you have six, because you can just use Salesforce workflow rules based on, you know, these three fields to update a million other things. So like we use that internally at Cloud for Good. When I send a proposal, just one, and I'm using Conga to generate the actual proposal, we just tick one box and there is a workflow based on a few things on the opportunity that updates many other things. So
It can definitely be an initiator, Tal.
Right.
That master filter set can initiate other things as well. But most of the time what we'll see people in the nonprofit space is they will have it, at least on a donation record, either a checkbox or a date field that will confirm that the acknowledgement was sent, so that as you're reporting later on, not only do you have an activity, but you can actually update those fields for your own process. So.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Great idea. So I'm going to jump back to Quick Merge just really quickly so we can see this. But anyway, I've specified all of my steps here just with template IDs. I'm turning on the bypass wizard, so I just skip through all of the steps and go straight to the download results page. You can certainly add in those log activity options as well if you wanted to do that all in one step without having to do that as a separate button click. And then just my report ID as my data source. You're basically preloading Mail Merge, Conga Mail Merge. You're basically preloading it up with all of your selections. And then all you have to do here is click launch, and it takes you directly to the end result page.
One of the best benefits, and sorry I'm going to interrupt Shelley just because it's something that's kind of near and dear to a lot of our nonprofit clients, is some of these processes are either done very frequently, and going through all the steps of the wizard can sometimes get a little tedious and time consuming. So having this quick merge where you just have a single launch button, not only does it make that easier if you do it frequently, but it also helps if you've got different people that are coming in and perhaps doing this maybe not on a regular basis. So the training and instruction maybe of a volunteer or a part-time person is much easier to say, go to Quick Merge, look at this exact Quick Merge, hit the button to launch, and they're done. That's really helpful, too, from a training and consistency standpoint. And also the flip side is if you do something maybe just once a year, having the Quick Merge link already be pre-built with the correct template, the correct label or envelope, and the correct report makes it a lot easier to duplicate if you do it less frequently. It's already preloaded, and it really makes it a very, very easy way to compress those steps.
Mm-hmm. So in the interest of time, I just have one quick other thing that I want to show you all, and then I definitely want to leave as much time as we can for questions. So really quickly, the other side of our application, Conga Composer, we just refer to as sort of Conga Composer versus Conga Mail Merge. So apologies if that's a little bit confusing, but the idea here is that rather than generating a batch of letters or labels or envelopes based on a report or a contact list or whatever, we're just going to go to one record. And we've built a custom button called Thank You Letter. You just click this. It launches this Conga dialog window. And we, on this particular one, have actually selected, once it loads, you'll see, an email template. So you can certainly do file templates like we did before, but I wanted to show you guys email just because this is a little bit different. And then same thing, I have a Conga email template loaded up into Salesforce. I'm going to do activity logging just like we did with Conga Mail Merge. I've got this automatic logging checked, so it's all going to happen as soon as I click this email button. And then you get the same status bar, just tells you Conga is gathering up that data from Salesforce and populating it into your email template. And then it takes us to the Salesforce email page, and everything is all populated for us, the subject, the body. I put a logo up here. You can see you can do tables. You can do images in here. I've got some bold text. So it's much more powerful than your typical Salesforce email template because you can get not only, you know, fields right off of a contact, for example, but if you had a related custom object that you can grab data from. So that master detail relationship comes into play again. And then, of course, the activity logging, again, everything's kept track of. So if I go to activity history, I've got that email that says it was sent.
So we have noticed, and Tal, I remember you and I talking about this a couple weeks ago, that in the nonprofit space, there's been a change that since Shelley and I started, that a high majority of people were using Conga Mail Merge and printing letters and labels and envelopes to send out and physically mail. And you know, the trend in that space has been we'd like to offer a non-hard copy solution to our donors or our supporters, and a lot more people are using Conga Composer to send email acknowledgments versus taking the time to print and mail and stuff and the labor to save that money for your programs and for your your activities that are key and not having that overhead. So a big change in being able to take that same information that we put into a letter template and now put it into a much more rich-looking email template that people can use for that acknowledgement and be able to use that as well. So just something that we've noticed in the past couple of years as a change.
Yeah, definitely a trend. I've gone over to the Conga website just so you guys can see. It's just congamerge.com. If you click this support page, we've got all sorts of resources, YouTube channel. This is our searchable knowledge base. And then down here at the bottom, all the ways to get in touch with us. So I'm going to pause there, and then hopefully Tal can sort of moderate on the questions.
Yeah, so we have a bunch of questions here. So first of all, about the wizard. So can you have one batch that uses different letter templates? So within one batch, can you use multiple letter templates?
Unfortunately not. For Conga Mail Merge, you're going to be locked into one letter template. So if you had that need, that's where I would probably go to Quick Merge, because it'll be much faster for you to have one Quick Merge record for each necessary template and just fire those off rather than having to go through the wizard.
Or the other option, by the way, so I'm assuming that this could be relevant, for example, if I want to generate it, put a little different text for a donor that gave more than X or donor that gave less than X number of dollars. Mm-hmm. You can use nested if formulas within the mail merge to do that. So that can be a kind of a nice workaround there.
Depending on kind of what those requirements are, you can put that dynamic
right. Logic
in a template exactly.
Yeah, yep. So what Tal's talking about would be right here in the Word template. We could build in some logic if it was just something, pretty straightforward, like different text based on the donor amount or maybe a different image or something like that.
I'm going to merge a few questions here to one question. Can you mail merge from multiple tables at the same time, so accounts and households and donations or opportunities at the same time, for example?
Definitely, yeah. So the example that Chris and I provided today was just a pretty straightforward one as a sort of introductory demonstration. But, yeah, that's where Conga Composer will really start to flex its muscles, and you can get certainly data from one master object and a bunch of different related objects.
We even have clients that are using it for reports, because sometimes the Conga merge has more robust capabilities to pull the data out of Salesforce than the Salesforce reports. So just to know about that.
Yeah, because you do have the ability to pull multiple reports at one time with that composer side of the application. So it's a great one.
Can you assign activities to another user, or do you have to attach it to your username?
With Mail Merge, you're going to be locked into your own username. So whoever's logged in and clicking that Log Activities button or who had launched the Quick Merge, those activities are going to be logged under, or assigned, I should say, to their user record. With Conga Composer, we have a bit more flexibility where you can assign those to an alternate user. So again, Composer would be the button just on one record like we showed on the contact.
Again, that's something that you can do a workaround with a workflow, though. Does Conga support...
Say, help me. Show me the ways.
Does Conga support metric pay performance like A4? It's a question all the way from South Africa.
Oh, great question. Yes, so obviously my little demo here was with US, 8.5 by 11. Sort of template, but yeah, certainly all you'd have to do is set up your Word document with your desired, document or letter dimensions, and then Conga will merge to it, no problem. We can also do different currencies, different languages, so certainly everything I've done here is just American dollars and the regular template size, but yeah, it'll work. That's why we have so many customers in 35 different countries, because you can customize that to your own international specifications.
Question here from Laura. If they purchase only one user to do the merge function, can others see the activity on the person's record? So
that would follow the regular visibility tell in Salesforce, that whatever activities were generated, if that other user had visibility and access to that record, they'd be able to see that the activity was done. So yeah. Unless there's sharing rules or other kinds of access, by default, If someone can see a contact or see a donation record, they'll be able to see all the activities associated with it.
Yeah, so Conga's not doing anything fancy or extra. It's just using whatever Salesforce permissions everybody has. It follows the same flow.
In fact, it's probably preferable to see all the activities just so that everyone is seeing the same consistent information.
Can be on the same page, yes.
I have a quick question here from Gordon about does it support professional edition of Salesforce?
Yes, definitely. The only edition we cannot support, unfortunately, is group, just because of the lack of API access.
API.
But yeah, professional all the way through unlimited. You're good to go.
And last question for today, can you send the emails as a batch? Similar to
Mail Merge. Mail Merge, we cannot do email whatsoever. So you're going to be looking at the Conga Composer tool to be able to do the emails. And we can do a batch email, but it does require one of those paid add-ons. The one that you would want is called Conga Conductor, and it's a batch processing tool that can handle email. So it's this guy right here. We have free 30-day trials of all of our products, so what I always sort of advise people to do is start with Composer and, you know, get and Mail Merge and get your arms around that. And then if you want to do one of those add-ons down the road, then we can do a free 30-day trial and there's no obligation. Or if you want to do them simultaneously, that's certainly fine too. But we do have the free 30 days with technical support included at no charge. So just try it out.
Yep. Sounds good. Well, guys, it's right on the minute here. So, Conga guys and girls, I would like to thank you for, you know, for really a great presentation. You know, I said earlier that I really like your app, and a lot of people are using the app. But I think that one of the reasons, in addition to the functionality that people are using the app, is the great support that you guys provide. So, just kudos for that. Yeah, really good job on supporting our clients, and that's why we're happy with everything.
And tell something that I think you understand, but it's always good to reemphasize, is that, you know, we have a, you know, 15 to 20% of our customers are from the nonprofit space. We're committed to supporting those customers and those needs, not only from the discount standpoint of offering that discount on our licensing, but any nonprofit customer, whether it's 3 people, 10 people, get the same level of support and attention as our biggest enterprise customers. We don't distinguish between that. If we need to spend, you know, an hour, hour and a half with a customer helping them, we're going to do that at no charge, just like we would for any other customer. So we've built our reputation on that, and you can rest assured that we're going to work with your customers in the way that you would like us to.
Yep.
Sounds
good.
Hopefully
I'll be on the Conga phones and hearing from some of you new folks out there. I work support, so if you give us a call. Definitely tell me you were on the webinar. It'd be fun to meet some people.
Sounds good. And this webinar is recorded, and it's going to be published on YouTube probably by the end of today. Thank you again, everyone, for joining us today. Please make sure to sign up for the rest of the Apps for Good webinars. Have a great day.
Thanks everyone.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Please stand by.